what is this now, the fourth Liam Neeson and Ame Call Sarah film? My god, these guys do a lot of films together, and they're all kind of similar. Entertaining, but similar. Hey everyone, welcome to The Reviewed. Here's my review for the movie The Commuter. Yes, The Commuter stars Liam Neeson, Patrick Wilson, Vera Farmiga, and Sam Neill. And this movie is directed by Ame Colasera, a guy who previously directed films like Orphan, House of Wax, and of course the Liam Neeson films like Unknown, Run All Night, and Nonstop. And now this is the fourth installment of their, you know, movies together. Yes, The Commuter. The Commuter is about a man who does a commute every day via train and stuff. And then one day something happens, something thrilling, something edgy happens. He gets in contact with someone and he has to find something on the train and stop something on the train before the next stop. And that's all I'm going to say, because this movie is a movie filled with like twists and turns, and it keeps you on the edge of your seat the whole time and stuff. It's one of those type of thrillers. The less you know about the film, the better. Yes, The Commuter and stuff, and yeah, The Commuter. I didn't know what to expect from this movie because this is a January film, and it's a Liam Neeson film, and yeah, I actually saw the Mark Felt film with Liam Neeson, a few weeks ago, and it was awful, so don't know if I was looking forward to this film because, wow, Liam Neeson hasn't really been knocking it out of the park lately, but I gotta say, The Commuter, pretty good film, actually. I actually kind of like this film. Man, this January is really not shaped up to be too bad, actually. The Commuter, yeah. I'm going to talk about Ame Colasera's films, especially the ones that he has with Liam Neeson. They're decent films. They're very throwaway, pretty disposable thrillers, but they're very entertaining films. Nonstop, Unknown, and Run All Night. They're not great films, but I find them very entertaining, very serviceable and stuff, and Liam Neeson's really great. Yes, basically his movies are like these kind of throwaway, kind of one-time watch sort of films, but they're still entertaining and still enjoyable for what they are. Yes, I think the movie Nonstop is probably the most ridiculous one out of the films, these Liam Neeson, Ame Colasera films and stuff. I think it's the weakest one out of the Liam Neeson ones, but the other ones are still pretty fine. I thought Unknown was a pretty enjoyable film, and even Run All Night was a pretty fun, entertaining movie as well. Honestly, I think now The Commuter is actually the better one. Out of these Liam Neeson, Ame Colasera films, I think The Commuter is the most enjoyable, most fun, most entertaining one. And yeah, it's the one I like the most. I thought Liam Neeson was actually really great in this film, The Commuter. I thought he was an enjoyable character. I thought he gave a good performance. And I liked him a lot in the film. I even liked Jonathan Banks, Vera Farmiga, Patrick Wilson, Sam Neill. I thought all of them gave pretty decent performances. I thought they were all pretty good. I even thought Ame Colasera's direction was pretty enjoyable. I thought he did a decent job. He added a lot of thrills and tension. He even put some twists and turns. Some of them are ridiculous, but you know what? They work for this sort of story and stuff. And I thought it was an entertaining hour and 45 minutes. It kind of flew by for me. It was an hour and 45 minutes. It flew by like that. I was actually entertained and quite impressed that this was a good January film. I thought this would either be a boring, just dull derivative film or just be a ridiculous, stupid action film. But honestly, it was actually a pretty enjoyable, pretty taut, intense, dramatic thriller with decent performances, decent action sequences when there is action, and yeah, it's enjoyable. I thought this was a very fun movie and a pretty good movie. Yeah, if you want to go see a movie and you saw all the big blockbuster films, all the Oscar contender films, you've seen them all, and you just want to watch a entertaining thriller, definitely I can recommend The Commuter. Is there flaws? Yes, there are some scenes that are ridiculous. There's some stuff that happens in this movie that are absolutely absurd. Some things make absolutely little to no sense. Some of the twists are even a bit forced. And again, it's nothing amazing or groundbreaking. It's nothing you'll probably have to watch it multiple times to actually get it or like it and stuff. Either you watch it and you hate it, or you watch it or you like it. And even if you do like it, it's probably not a film you're going to watch multiple times and stuff. Again, it's like these one-time watch entertaining films. And honestly, I was entertained and I actually had fun with this film. And I think out of Ame Colasera's films, which are films consisted of either bad films or just fun disposable films, I think this is one of his better films. And actually had fun with it, and I could definitely recommend it. It's deeply flawed. It's nothing you have to see desperately, but if you want to go watch an entertaining thriller, definitely check it out. I will definitely recommend The Commuter. Shockingly, I will recommend it. So yeah, on a scale of 1 to 10, I'm going to give the movie The Commuter a 7.7 out of 10. So yeah, check it out. If you like Liam Neeson and you like this filmmaker, you'll like this film. So yeah, that was my review for the movie, The Commuter. So in the comment section below, please tell me, what is your favorite movie that stars Liam Neeson and is directed by Ame Kalasira? Yes, they have four films together. Out of these four films, what is your favorite out of these four films? My favorite is The Commuter, and my least favorite is Nonstop. But what is your favorite? What is your least favorite? Comment below, let me know. And as always, with this video, please like, subscribe to this channel, and join the dark side.